Hello everybody, welcome back to Jersh Reacts. In today's video, we're going to react to The Weeknd After Hours. I've reacted to The Weeknd a couple of times in the past. The first song that I reacted to was about not being able to feel his face and drugs. And then the other time that I reacted to him, it was his collaboration with Lana Del Rey. So he's not been in my regular rotation, but I am familiar kind of with his voice and his singing capabilities. But Patreon producer Rootbeer decided it had been too long since I have reacted to The Weeknd, so he requested that I react to this song. So that's why we're here. If you like what you see on my channel, make sure you like the videos and subscribe. If you want to support me further to keep the channel around long term or become a Patreon producer yourself, I have links in this video description for my Patreon, as well as my Twitch Prime and my merch store. So as far as I know, there is not an official music video for this song. So we just have the song here, which is a 6-minute song. So I'm curious to see what it's about. And I've got the lyrics ready to go. Is it about the fight that caused his bloody nose? I don't know, but here we go. Thought I almost died in my dream again. Such a great singer. Fighting for my life, I couldn't breathe again. Sensing a little auto-tune there, though. Interesting melody. Weird kind of sounding song. This feels like the song is building up to something, which, I mean, of course, a lot of songs do. But this one in particular, with the restraint of the bass drum, the constant repetition of that single note, and how the song opened, it's opened with just two chords back and forth, like an A minor G. And now, just as we've got into the 2-minute mark, a third chord started to show up. So I really feel like it is going to, I think it's going to build and expand and really build up, especially, I don't know, there's just something about music. Normally you expect a song to be around 3 or 3.5 minutes. You start to get into the 4-minute range, the 5-minute range. For me, as just as a musician and as a listener of music, I'm anticipating some sort of long bridge, a breakdown, a guitar solo, a vocal solo, something crazy. And so the fact that this is a 6-minute song and so much of it, a third of it, has been dedicated to kind of the slower pace makes me think that that's why it's building. And it's a great sound. It's an interesting melody. I think he does have just a good natural singing voice. I don't even think he probably needs auto-tune. It's probably a choice for an effect. Let's see what these... I have no idea what the lyrics were saying, though, because the way that he sings, though, it's... For me, like, I can hear... I hear, like, individual instruments really well, but I don't hear lyrics really well. So that's why I also like to double-check the lyrics regardless, even if I heard them clearly the first time. I thought I almost died in my dream again, fighting for my life. I couldn't breathe again. I'm falling in too deep. Without you, I can't sleep because my heart belongs to you. I'll risk it all for you. I want you next to me. This time I'll never leave. I want to share babies, protection we won't need. All right. Your body next to me is just a memory. I'm falling in too deep. Without you, I can't sleep. Insomnia relieved. Talk to me. Without you, I can't breathe. So yeah, I don't think this is like the typical, oh, I'm in love with you. Like, I want to make your babies. I did not know that that's what he was singing about when the lyrics first passed through me. But good sound, interesting lyrics. Let's keep going. Getting some more instrumentation here. I like the crackling record sound effect too. I think that's cool. Just staring at his bloody face because there's no video. Really like the effect on that music in the background. Get to 4 minutes and then we'll stop it again. Good melody on that music too. Let's rewind. Yeah, we'll rewind a little bit so I missed that transition. So yeah, so the percussion dropped. The synth drum came in and we're getting now more digital effects and more instrumentation building up. It's also interesting to me that he sings at such a high octave so solidly. It's really impressive. Let's take a look at what some more of the lyrics are saying. Let's see if he wants to keep making her babies. My darkest hour, girl, I felt so alone inside this crowded room. Different girls on the floor distracted my thoughts of you. Turned into the man I used to be. To put myself to sleep, just so I can get closer to you inside my dreams. Didn't want to wake up unless you were beside me. Just wanted to call you and say, where are you now when I need you most? I'd give it all just to hold you close. Sorry I broke your heart. Never coming down, I was running away from facing reality. Wasting all my time out of living fantasies. Spending money to compensate because I want you. I'd be living in heaven when I'm inside of you. It was simply a blessing, waking beside you. I'll never let you down again. I feel like this is very specific. I think a lot of pop songs do a lot of different things. Usually with the love songs that I react to here, it's either usually about a real specific thing that happened to them in real life, or it's a complete fiction that they're writing from a fantasy of like a breakup or a love story, or it's based in real life, but then aspects of it are changed to give it a more universal appeal. So it has like a nugget of truth, but a lot of it is not real. I feel like a lot of this is based on a very specific circumstance and a situation. I don't think if The Weeknd was trying to, you know, make this mass appeal love song about being in love with somebody, I don't think it would come down to let's procreate. I think it would come down to hooking up, you know, but maybe not actually like starting a family together. There's just not a lot of pop songs that kind of go that far, you know? I want to pay bills with you. I want to argue about our property taxes with the local government with you. I want to argue about whose turn is it to take out the trash with you. I want to decide who's going to mow the lawn on the riding lawnmower and who's going to run the weed whacker with you. And then, if the lawnmower breaks, was that your turn? Or whose turn is it now that it's broken? Marshall, who the fuck's turn is it? Sorry, I went off on a tangent. All right. Yeah, I feel like this is very specific about it, an actual real scenario that he went through. Where are you now when I need you most? So clearly he fucked up. I'll treat you better than I did before. I'll not let you go. I won't break your heart this time. So yeah. The things we do to the people we say we love. All right, let's keep going. That almost has like a Silent Hill effect on it. Like Silent Hill 2 music, anybody? It's all my fault. Made you put down your guard. Lower octave now. I know I made you fall. And said you were wrong for me. I lied to you, I lied to you, I lied to you. Can't hide the truth, I stayed with her in spite of you. You did some things that you regret, still right for you. Cause this house is not a home without my baby. And back up. Where are you now when I need you most? I give it all just to hold you close. Sorry that I broke your heart. Your heart. And I said baby, I'll treat you better. Wow, it went the opposite. Interesting. I guess it makes sense considering the somber tone and serious subject matter of the song. So what it did was it kind of crescendoed around the 4-minute mark, around 2/3, kind of the way a movie crescendos at the end of the second act, breaking into the third act. And then the last 90 seconds or so of the song, it was just kind of like the aftermath, you know, the epilogue. After all of the fight and the emotions and everything built up, it like calmed down and he kind of was kind of accepting his new reality almost. So yeah, I thought it was going to build up and kind of what we got around 2/3 of the way through the song, I thought was going to happen at the end. But it makes sense that it would build up and then kind of have this exhale at the end where we're out of breath and we're still trying to gasp these lyrics out, that kind of thing. So that's really cool. Let's see. I know it's my fault, made you put down your guard. I know I made you fall, then said you were wrong for me. I lied to you. Can't hide the truth. I'd stay with her in spite of you. You did some things that you regret, still ride for you, because this house is not a home without my baby. Where are you now? Yeah. So he definitely fucked up. And then, he made a mistake, he hurt somebody's feelings, and then he wrote a song about it, and now he gets to profit off of that pain. Ain't life grand? I don't know, that's weird. Yeah, I've said it before and I'll say it again, it's really interesting to me to have people going through painful experiences and then making music out of it and then liking the music. I feel like there's almost like a guilt all around. Like, should you have profited off of that? Should I be liking this subject matter, considering what you had to go through because it was really painful for you? I don't know. It's kind of, I have mixed emotions about that. But beautiful song. It was a ton of lyrics. There was a lot of lyrics in that song. Justifiably so with a 6-minute song. I really liked the music. I liked the effects on it. I liked the melody was really interesting. And I also liked how 90% of the song was in his traditional higher octave, and then when he went lower, like to break it down and like get real, get serious, like I felt the difference because of the change in the octave. So that was really cool. If you like this video, make sure you like and subscribe. Comment down below. Let me know what this song means to you. And if you have any other requests for reactions on my channel. As always, thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.